Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Molly Gabler-Smith, and I'm a postdoctoral researcher at Harvard University. Today, I will be talking to you about the fascinating world of skin. So let's dive right in. When we think about the surfaces of animals, we know that there are many different kinds of structures that can cover an animal's skin. For example, there are animals that are covered in fur or spines. I'm going to focus today on animals that are covered in scales. And so if you can think of any of the types of animals that are covered in scales, maybe some of these animals you have caught or have as pets. So we know that all fish have scales, which you may have felt if you have ever caught a fish. Even squid have scales. Geckos also have these really cool scales on the bottoms of their foot pads. And snakes also have scales, which you may have seen or felt if you have ever seen shed snake skin. So let's take a look at another image. What animal do you think these scales belong to? Well, if any of you guessed sharks, you are correct. This is in fact an image of shark skin. Each of these tiny elements are the scales, which in sharks are called denticles. In fact, sharks are covered in thousands of these denticles. Specifically, we are looking at the skin of the nurse shark, this particular shark skin in fact. These denticles are from the body just under the dorsal fin shown here. Now this one was in a net, but we can see what they would normally look like swimming at the rocky bottom shown here in the bottom left. Scientists call these scales denticles because they are made up of the same material that your teeth are made up of. That is enamel and dentin. So sharks are covered in thousands of tiny teeth. What's also cool about denticles is that all sharks are covered in them, yet no two denticles are alike. I have some examples of denticles we see in three different types of sharks on the left. The chain cat shark is on the top, the sand tiger shark is in the middle, and the great white shark, which we all know is on the bottom. As you can see, all of these denticles differ in their size. The sand tiger shark denticles are larger than the great white sharks, and they also differ by their shape. So the chain cat shark denticles are more triangular compared to the sand tiger shark, which look more like a spatula. And if that wasn't crazy enough, denticles differ in size and shape within an individual. This image on the right shows a bonnethead shark, and you can see from these black and white pictures that the denticles on the nose are much different than the denticles on the tail. Why are these denticles important for sharks? Well, denticles have many different functions, some of which include protection. This could be protection from other sharks or just protection against rubbing against another surface. The denticles also reduce bacterial growth. This has to do with their specific shape and surface texture. And denticles also allow for some species of sharks to swim really fast through the water, which we will talk more about in a bit. So how do we study shark denticles? Well, I work in the Museum of Comparative Zoology at Harvard, which houses hundreds of thousands of individual fishes. Shown here is one of them. So what I do is I search the collection for the individual shark that I'm interested in, like this sleeper shark here, and then I can study its denticles in a variety of different ways. I have this ruler here on the right to show you again size differences in shark denticles. Each mark is about 1 millimeter. And so you can see it in this picture of sleeper shark denticles. They can be about 1,000 microns in length, which would be about 1 millimeter. So these are relatively large denticles. In contrast, the shortfin mako shark has really tiny denticles. You can even see an individual denticle on the tip of someone's finger. These denticles are only about 0.1 millimeters in length. So much smaller than the sleeper shark denticles. And so because denticles can vary drastically in size, there are many different ways we can study them. The first is through microscopy. Like I mentioned earlier, the denticles of the sleeper shark and nurse shark are so big, they can easily be viewed under a light microscope, which I'm using here on the left. This method allows us to quickly look at the diversity of scales along a shark's body. The second method I use is called profilometry, which allows me to study the surface topography of the skin. You can think about this like looking at a topographic map, which would show you the differences in elevation across a certain area of land. This method allows me to visualize how tall denticles are, what their ridges look like, and how many peaks and valleys there are. The third method is called microcomputed tomography scanning, in which I use the device pictured here in order to get a three-dimensional scan of the shark skin. So here are some images of the types of data we can collect with each of these methods. Using microscopy, you can see the individual denticles from a sleeper shark here on the left. You can even see that denticles lack pigment or color. That is why they appear almost clear. In the center, you can see the types of data collected by using the surface topography method. The top image is a grayscale picture of the surface of a chain-cat shark. Below this image is another image showing a heat map of the surface. The red areas are tall sections of the skin, and the blue areas are low. You can see that some of the ridges on the individual denticles are relatively tall, about 140 microns. Finally, using the CT scanner, we can collect data based on the three-dimensional structure of the denticles. And we can take this data and use it to 3D print models of the denticles. And so I'm going to show you some examples of the sleeper shark denticles that are enlarged so we can see some of the interesting characteristics like the ridges. So this is one of the sleeper shark denticles that we have 3D printed. You can see it's relatively small, but it's also got these points. As the denticle gets bigger, you can start to see some of the ridges shown here. Some of these denticles get really big, and you can see it almost looks like a spatula. We can even print these on foils and test the different denticle shapes in the flow tank. And so this is a foil. We've printed small denticles on this foil, and what we can do is put it in a flow tank and test how water moves around it. And this becomes important because of the third function of shark denticles that I mentioned earlier. So remember that third function was to allow sharks to swim fast. And so why would we humans care about shark denticles? Well, in fact, because shark denticles allow some sharks to swim efficiently through the water, we have used denticle-like surfaces for many human applications. Sharklet uses denticle-like surfaces to prevent bacterial growth on certain structures. Street shark prints car hoods with a denticle-like surface in order to achieve faster driving speeds. Even planes can be coated with denticle-like surfaces. And finally, many of you may be aware of Speedo shark-inspired fast skin swimsuits that enable swimmers to glide through the water at faster speeds. And so I hope you enjoyed learning about shark denticles, and I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have.